episode 2446, Are You Playing on the Wrong Team?
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. I hope you're ready for an extraordinary weekend. It's a brand new Monday. It's Mindset Monday, and it is time to really think about where you're headed. Maybe you've got a lot of stuff going on. Have you looked at your calendar? Take a deep breath, because now is a moment in time where you get to be present so you can make an impact on the future of the world that you touch by doing what you need to do right now. But are you playing on the wrong team? For those of you who are brand new to Creation Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already haven't had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. Are you playing on the wrong team? Looking over your shoulder, comparing yourself to what others are doing, slows down progress. Lead where you stand. Have you ever thought about really how you lead in your life? Most of us don't take time to do that. We don't reflect. We're too busy. We're always moving on just to the next thing. We've got too much going. I get it. But I got to ask you, have you indulged in a little sports this weekend? Maybe you've enjoyed your child playing ball, or, you know, whether that be football or volleyball. Maybe some people have softball still going on. It all depends on the area. You've got college ball. Yeah, sign me up. I'm there. NFL ball. Sign me up. I'm there too. You know, and you also can't leave out tennis and baseball. There is so much happening. In fact, you probably could find almost any sport you wanted to watch. Tis the season. They even have golf on. The Ryder Cup's coming up, and you have tennis. Let's see, you also have, I think I even saw drag racing. Okay, there's so much to fill your cup if you're a sports fanatic like I am. But what I love most about this season is what it can teach us. Yes, any moment can be a teachable moment, even while we watch sports. And I know you're thinking, well, do I not get a time off? You do, but the thing is, you can't always be leading from behind, as in always feeling like you're catching up. And so you use your moments in life because, you see, they're God winks. They're the teachable moments. It says, look, here, I want you to pay attention right here. Do you see this? So as I was watching the Kansas City Chiefs and the Baltimore Ravens play, maybe you watched the game too, I was fascinated by how some players watched and were concerned about what the other player was doing, looking behind or over the shoulder. Yes, I think my children have heard me say this so many times. They're running forward but looking backwards. How does that help? It doesn't, because it's going to slow you down. But the ones who kept focus on where they were headed and simply keeping their eye on the plan, whether it was the eye on the ball, or I've got to tackle this guy, or I'm headed for the end zone, the goal was achieved at a more consistent rate. Many of us are looking too much at what others are doing. The distractions keep you from moving forward and can keep you stuck. And I know there are times that we need to lock on to people to be aware of what they're doing, so it gives us ideas. But it's one thing to sit there and say, but I want to be like them. If you want to escape the comparison and move your dreams forward, you've got to lead from where you stand. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. Lead from where you stand. That's LEAD. Love that word. You've got to let go of what you can't control and do what you can control. If you lock on to what others are doing and try to emulate them all the time, you can kiss your dream or goal goodbye. You can't. I know, been there, done that. And it doesn't work. Now, again, if you want to take it from a perspective of, I want to see what they're doing, and then I want to move forward, or you're looking up to them as more of a mentor, that's a different perspective versus saying, oh my gosh, I've got to be just like them. And no, those aren't the words that we say. I mean, come on, be real. We don't say, I want to be like this person. I mean, can you imagine me saying I want to be like Elon Musk? Okay, I don't know always where he is as a visionary. I can understand that. I'm a visionary. But some of the things that he has conceptually come up with, I'm like, okay, I would get there, but I wouldn't know how to put it into action. And for me, that's like, okay, that's cool on one part, but on the other part, I'm like, oh, I so get lost. And then what would happen if I focused only on that? If I wanted to be like him, I'm going to get stuck going, I'm never going to reach over here. I get this part, but I can't perceive this part. And so I get myself lost. I think, oh, I've got to go out and get another certification. I've got to go and, you know, figure out what I'm going to do over here in order to make my job move here. It just gets to be crazy and not in a good way. So if you lock onto what others are doing and try to emulate them, you're going to kiss your dream and go goodbye. So how do you lead from where you stand? L-E-A-D. Let's break it down. Number one, locate. That's your L, locate. Where are you? You got to know where you are. And then you have to know where do you want to go. That's important. But you don't focus on where you want to go. What do you focus on? The next step, right? Connecting where you are now versus where you are headed. This is recognizing the importance of your presence so you can simplify your next step. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. That's how you get to where you want to go, because it's just that next step. You want to write a book? Well, are you writing? Maybe you should start writing. I don't know where to start. Well, why don't you sit down and don't even think about it and just write? And by the way, sidebar here, if you want to be a writer, sit down and just write. Do not edit what you write. You don't edit until you come back later. And that means not an hour later after writing. That means days after, sometimes months after. So allow yourself that freedom just to write. That's what you need to do. What is that immediate next step? You got to locate it. Number two, E, evaluate and examine your strengths and your weaknesses. What do you need to get to where you want to go? What is that one thing that you need? Do you really need to go get a certification in order to do what you want to do? Do you need to look at, okay, if I'm going to quit my job and stay home permanently, then what's really my next step? Do I have a contract that I have to give a certain amount of notice? Okay, then maybe that needs to be where you start. So you have an idea as to, okay, the calendar, that means if I gave notice here, that means I can't leave here, right? You got that? But the problem is we're just kind of pushing our way through, or we're always looking over our shoulder. You got to examine and evaluate. And of course, you can look at others for examples and mentorship, which I mentioned, but don't get caught up in what they're doing. Be quick to turn what you learn into action. And I want you to think about that a lot. Be quick to turn what you learn into action. Because if not, you're just going to sit there. And you don't want to sit there because you want to move to what? A, number three, aim. Action ignites motivation. You have got to make your move. You've got to build up your courage by what? Doing. It's the do. And understand this. Some people say, well, but what if I'm waiting? Waiting is doing. It is an action. It's also a decision. So I get a lot of the, but I'm waiting on the Lord. Okay, great. You can wait on him, but there's still a next step involved. It doesn't mean that you get to sit on the couch and eat bonbons, right? That's not waiting. That's being lazy. I'm just saying. I'm calling it out like it is. Life is too short. Life is precious. You have a gift, and you need to share it with the world that you touch. You're created for more. So stop settling for somebody else's life and lead your life. Take aim today. Action ignites motivation. And finally, number four, D, is discipline. Be willing to do the work. Work on you and create your best selfie. That's the key here. The key is not trying to be Elon Musk. Him and I, oh yeah, we would have a great conversation when it comes to mindset and vision and mission. I get all of that. I'm like right up there with them. But man, if I have to take all of that and put it into a conceptual design, like space stuff, now I know you're probably telling me, but he hires people for that. I get that. But his mind is also a little bit different than mine. And he can see things that I don't always understand. And the vision part, I get all that. But sitting here and taking something and saying, okay, this is where we're going to go. And he knows exactly who to line up and what to do and how to what. Put it into action. And then he disciplines himself. And he figures out what is the next step. You got to be willing to do the work. And you got to work on you. You can't focus on what somebody else is doing. Him and I may have vision in common, but if I sit here and focus on what he's doing, do you think I'm ever going to get to what God has put within me? No, it won't happen because I'm going to try to be like him and there's only one Elon Musk. This is not about trying to do everything all at once, but doing the once all the time. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. Don't overwhelm yourself. Don't get yourself trapped in comparison. Don't lead because of what everybody else is doing. You've got to be willing to step into your greatness. Don't shy away from that. You're created for more. You're made for more. So this week, I want this week to be a different week. Did you know fall officially lands this week? I know, kind of crazy. We're coming out of summer. I'm like, seriously? Now our weather's still hot. We can still swim. Pool's still open. Woohoo. But I say all that. Guess what? It means a new season. We're about ready to be in the last quarter of 2021. Don't you want to do something this quarter now instead of waiting until January 1st of 2022? I mean, seriously, think about it. Whatever that goal is, whatever your dream is, don't you want to be putting it into motion? Or do you want to wait and have another year click in? And then, oh, wait, and another year click in. So now it's not just 2021, 2022. We're now 2023 into 2024. And you're sitting here going, didn't I just hear this episode before? But 4 years later. One step at a time leads to miles of greatness. You have got to start taking action. You've got to stop making up excuses. You've got to stop looking over your shoulder. Because I'm here to tell you, you're playing on the wrong team if you don't know that answer. You are. You're trying to play on everybody else's team. Stop trying to get noticed because of what others are doing. Trying to be like someone else. Be you, right? You got this. Be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.